Hi, welcome to CS On Air in association with Women Tech Makers. This is the first of a series of two special editions last week of informal interviews with women in engineering. Today I'm pleased to be joined by Dr. Eva Navarro-López, who is a lecturer and researcher at Manchester University in computer science. My name's Alison, and I'm in the Google Zurich office alongside Maria Lena, and we have Lynette also joining us from the Google London office. So, Eva, could you start off by telling us a little bit about your background, both your current role and what you did before, and also a little bit about what you enjoy most about your research?
Hello. Thank you very much for inviting me to talk. So, I am a research fellow and a lecturer in the School of Computer Science in Manchester in the United Kingdom, and this means that my work is driven by research. But I also supervise students at every level. I teach and I do many other things in the university. So I haven't followed a conventional career path or studies. So my very well kept secret is that I have a degree in computer science. And I always say that probably I'm not a proper computer science. And now it is the first time that I work in my career in a pure computer science department. So it is some kind of coming back to my origins or closing a circle. So I started by a degree of computer science, and I was doing two more parallel degrees in electronics and physical systems engineering. And after that, I wanted to really learn mathematics. So I started a PhD in space dynamics and celestial mechanics. But I also wanted to build robots. So I went to work for an institute of robotics and automatic control. After I helped to build some robots, some walking leg robots, I decided that I wanted to learn more mathematics, and I made a proper PhD in automatic control in Barcelona. And all of these diverse background made me very well placed to go to work in Mexico City for the oil industry. So I was controlling mechanical vibrations in oil well drill strings. So after that, after the experience in industry, I wanted to come back to academia. So I decided that I had to make a cocktail of all the theories that I have learned, mathematics, control, engineering, which is my career has been centered in control engineering. Also a mixture with computer science, of course, all the theory, computational theory, formal verification, and recently network science. So all of this is what it is called, the theory of hybrid dynamical systems. The applications are vast. So I have made applications from mechanical systems, electrical engineering, power converters, and now recently in ecology or neuroscience. So to the question, what I enjoy more about
work. Hey, we're back. Yeah, hang on, Eva. Sorry, your white noise came back, but I think that you're okay again now. Hang on. Oh, we can't hear you.
Still on mute, I think.
I was saying that what I enjoy most in my work is research, and some kind of breaking the boundaries of disciplines, and some kind of combining everything to create a new thing, and that is what computer science is allowing me, some kind of that creativity, that multidisciplinary research, that sometimes is difficult to find in other disciplines. So this creativity, I love the freedom of thinking. It's some kind that you are free to think whatever you want. There are limitations. You can do whatever you want if you have the proper background. So I love to learn every day from everybody and to connect ideas and to discover things, new things and new applications. That is what I enjoy most in my work.
Great, thank you.
So it can be hard for someone who's thinking about studying computer science at the university level to really understand what that's like. Based on your experience at Manchester as well as the other institutions you've been a part of, what does studying CS really entail?
I think so that the students have to have clear in their minds that there are many walls within computer science. So computer science is more than programming, is more than computers. So what does the computer science degree entails? It depends on what you want to do. You can have a degree which is computer science with mathematics. You can have a degree which is more oriented to computer engineering or architectures. You can have a degree with software, more with software engineering, so you are more based in the development of software. So I think so that you can also have business applications with computer science or more in industry oriented. So I think so that what it entails is an open mind. Be prepared. You have to really choose what is the branch of computer science that you really feel that it is the one that is going to fill your heart, and you are going to feel motivated. So it will entail whatever. It depends on the part of computer science that you choose.
What is it like, Eva, in yes. terms of the style of it? You know, when people come, will they be spending a lot of time in classrooms or in lecture theatres or in working in groups when they're studying? Or how does it feel like?
Both. I think so that because computer science is such a multidisciplinary area, so you had to learn how to work in teams. So I think so that there are three main, what they are going to see when they come in the first year, in computer science. So they are going to have theory classes, of course, because I think so that in computer science, the fascinating thing that there is a reconciliation between the abstract world and the practical world. So you can make incredible abstract things with the mathematical and logical thinking, but you have the practical mind. What that is differs you probably from mathematicians. So you want to always put things into practice. So you are, of course, you are going to have theoretical classes. You are going to have some course in mathematics, some course related to logic, so fundamentals of computation. You are going to have courses more related to hardware. So you are going to go to the lecture to learn this theory. And normally there is always associated labs to each course. Normally per hour of lecture you are going to have 1 or 2 hours of labs. And that is going to be the application of all the concepts that you learned in the class. Even for programming. Because you don't need to come to the university to learn how to program. You can self-learn that. But the important thing of the degree of computer science is that it teaches you to that the structure underneath programming. So once you learn one language, and if you are a good programmer, you can use any other languages because your mind is prepared for that. So it is a mixture, and there is also in computer science, you can also have courses to do teamwork, because you have to educate the students from the beginning that computer science is going to be a teamwork in their careers, in research, in companies, or whatever they do. Computer science is going to be some kind of a collective work.
Brilliant. Thank you very much. Can I ask, in computer science, maybe it's unlike a lot of other degrees where you know, you actually have the chance to not just be learning things, but actually be making things that you can be using as you're going through. You know, for somebody, say, studying a first year course in computer science, what kind of things could they expect to build?
It depends. It depends of your imagination. I think so that there are no limitations. So if you are a person that it is oriented in the part of mathematics, probably you will try to apply your skills or your programming skills to build a simulator of a dynamical system, a robot, or to even to make pictures of fractals from chaos theory. That is the part. If you are a software engineer, probably you would like to build an application for, you use your programming skills to, I don't know, to build an application to sell things, a web application to build things among your friends. What can you build? Anything that you want, indeed, or anything that I think so that there is such a variety of things that you can build. Even you can build hardware. If you are in that part of hardware, you can build some kind of devices that are more hardware than software. So I think so that it depends. So I would really advise students that they come to the first year looking ahead, really thinking of what really they like of computer science, so they stick with that and they start reading things about research about those areas. So then they have the vision of the future, because sometimes you feel that what you study in the first year is going to lead you nowhere. And it is, you say, but what is the fun of all of this? So in the first year you are going to learn a lot of foundations. And so you have to look ahead and to try to contact members of the staff, some inspiring lecturer that you have. So you ask them, what do they do in their research? Or you read computer science magazines to try to see what can you do with all the things. So the answer could be is very broad. It depends on what you really want. And it is such an imaginative job that you can do whatever you want. Just if you have the proper foundations to do that, in the theoretical background, of course.
Great, thank you. And I think we'll have some school students or some maybe secondary school teachers watching today. And what's your advice really for someone who's in school today thinking about studying computer science? How can they tell if it's something that they would be good at or would enjoy doing?
I think so that every of us, we know what we really enjoy. So you have to look inside you. First of all, I think so that there are several levels. So you look inside you and you follow your heart. And you know what you really, when you really enjoy something, because you want to talk to everybody about it. And you are looking forward to find time to study that. So that is one level. So we know when we enjoy something. And then, again, I would advise the students when they are at the school.
There we go.
Courses. Again, what I would advise the students is that they see ahead of the courses of the degree. And they start understanding the computer science is more than the computer science degree and what they are going to study. And because it's such an imaginative area, I think so that they had to really start reading what is going on in magazines. For example, if they are going to go to a department that they really like, they should check the research of the members of the staff. To some kind to have the flavor of all the things that they can do. If there is some profile that they think that it is really inspiring, why not to call them? We are willing to talk to students. We are willing to show them, and if they can come to visit us, they can see us working. Why not to take that opportunity? Because really, it seems that not, but we are really willing to talk to students. So I would advise them to get more implicated, to get really in touch with the things that they want to pursue in their career.
Great, thank you.
You've given us some really good tips for how to get started. I was wondering if you could tell us a little bit more about what got you started. What was the initial hook that got you in computer science? And maybe if you were starting out today, is there anything that you would do differently or you would do in addition to what you did when you first started out?
Yeah, I couldn't change anything at all of my career, because I have done what I have wanted to do in every moment. So I am very happy of everything that I have done. Even there has been very peculiar things that I have done in my career, but that has given me a great background. So, how I started for not being a proper computer science, I started programming. I was 11, 12 years old, and it was strange in those times in Spain and the type of schools, public schools that I was attending. So there wasn't usual programming courses. So suddenly one person came and said, oh, we are going to have an hour of programming. So my parents enrolled me. And there was the time that you were programming and you store your programs in cassettes. But what amazed me, I think so that I have passed by several stages. This first stage was the fact of coding and seeing that I could paint a clown on the screen. That was impressive, and I was saying, my God, just coding, and then I can, the things that I can do with coding. Then I passed to the phase of being fascinated by the idea, the philosophical idea of artificial intelligence and virtual reality. There was the times that I was reading magazines about artificial intelligence. And then suddenly I wanted to model the human brain. So I was intrigued by the artificial neural networks. And that was my process. But suddenly, just before entering the university, I thought that computer science was the only degree that could allow me to build a robot. From the beginning to the end, from the programming, from the design of the electronics, from the hardware to the software, from the control to the understanding of the dynamics, the mathematical analysis of the dynamical behaviors. So I chose computer science to build a robot. So this is some kind of my process. And then I studied computer science to leave computer science world and to build my career center in control theory and control engineering. So that was some kind of my journey in computer science, and now I come back.
Great. Well, thank you very much, Eva. That's been really interesting, and I think particularly important thing that you said was that, you know, students should approach computer science departments, can approach computer science departments, and really find out what are they doing, what does it really look like, and get the full information so that to help them make an informed decision. So I'd also like to thank Lynette and Maria Elena for joining us as well on the Hangout. This Hangout's been recorded, and it's going to be held at youtube.com/edu@Google. And we're back later this week on Thursday with a special UK Mothers Edition Hangout. We're going to be talking to Marzia Nicolai, who is a technical program manager at Google in London, and her mum, who is a software engineer at Boeing in California. So we'll see you all there. And for everybody, have a good afternoon. Bye-bye.
Okay. Bye. Thank you. Bye. Bye.